happens when you have a bump on your head and you wake up with foreign language syndrome.
Okay.
You don't speak in a foreign language, you speak in a foreign accent.
Clever.
Is correct. Clever. That's exactly right. You could just feel the trap door opening and closing.
Because if you could speak another language, then all I'd have done at school is just bash my head off the desk and go, oh!
Bonjour.
No.
Ça va? Oui, ça va bien. Merci.
No, it's just you just speak in the accent. Well,
why did you do that face?
I don't know.
I'm imagining smoking a Gaulois cigarette as well.
That's very odd.
Ça va bien. Merci beaucoup.
What? It's so weird how you turn into a cartoon. You're absolutely right. They simply have an impairment, a speech impairment. And the notion that they speak a foreign language, it's in the ear of the listener rather than in the mouth of the speaker. Sufferers have included George Michael. I don't know if you remember this. In 2012, he had pneumonia and he was briefly in a coma and he woke up with what sounded like...
You've got to have a faith. Rock your body.
No, he had a West Country.
Oh.
He had a West Country.
You've got to have faith.
A faith, you've got to have faith.
Oh, he had a careless whisper, he did.
Yeah. This is a terrible story. There was a Norwegian woman called Astrid L, and she was hit in the head by shrapnel during World War II in an air raid, and it left her with a German accent. But it was a speech impairment, and it resulted in her being ostracised by other Norwegians because they thought that she had somehow been associating with the Germans.
I heard someone on This Morning went on, they'd had some organ transplant, and when they woke up, they were really into vacuuming.
Well, so this is not as weird as it sounds. The answer may be that some memory exists in cells where we didn't know they resided before.
Wow.
That you would pass on vacuuming is really annoying. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.